Hey guys, welcome back to Live Your Style. I'm Sharrah, and today's video is sponsored by Molecule. I'm gonna tell you guys a little bit more about that later today, but this whole video is all about cleaning. Now, I'm not talking about basic cleaning like vacuuming or just wiping down things. I'm talking about those items that we all forget to clean. And I don't want this to be just me showing you how to clean or what to kind of be aware of when it comes to germs and bacteria. I want you guys to do it with me. So go get your, you know, clothes on that you clean in, go get your all-purpose cleaner and a rag and whatever else you're gonna need. And then just take your phone or whatever and follow around your house and we're gonna clean. And before we jump into cleaning, y'all know if you have not yet subscribed, hit that subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up if you guys like a clean house. And if you guys are not clean people, you're messy people, just give it a thumbs up anyway because you should like a clean house even if you don't have one. I'm a messy person and my house is not always clean. Serious. Number one, clean out your purse. Okay, if you guys are anything like me, you probably have a giant purse that has everything that you might need in any sort of situation possible inside that purse. Unfortunately, you can't access really any of those things in your purse or ever find them. That is my story, and I am just sick of that and done with it. So, if you guys have not grabbed your purse, I honestly want you to pause the video and go get your purse, and let's get serious. Once you have your purse, take your purse and go like this and start to separate. And I want you to throw away all the gum wrappers, all the random receipts that you don't need anymore. Yeah, all that stuff needs to go. And maybe even consider cutting back on the 5 different lipstick shades that you have in your purse. Maybe pick 2 and an easy to access spot in your purse so you know where they are and they don't fall into the deep dark corners of your purse where you can never find them. But once it's clean, you're gonna feel so much better and actually be able to get to things, which is kind of the main goal. Number 2. Now that our purses are clean, it's time to clean our air. What the heck do I mean by that? I'm gonna talk to you guys about air purifiers and specifically about the Molecule right over here. My whole life, I've pretty much grown up with air purifiers because my brothers had asthma, my dad was obsessed with air purifiers. We always had some giant, ugly box air purifier that was like an eyesore in our house that my mother hated, but my dad loved. So for us, when we had our first place, we noticed that we were getting a lot of dust, a lot of dirt. Tyler was sneezing all the time. And since we live in an old place, I'm sure our house has a lot of old harmful chemicals somewhere in the paint or the wall or the lining or something. I really wanted to get an air purifier to kind of clean that out because we really needed one. I actually saw a mailer for Molecule and was like, gosh, that is like the most beautiful air purifier I have ever seen. And then like a week or two later, they emailed me and they're like, hey, we'd love for you to try out the air purifier. So I was like, and let me tell you people, the science of it is super fun. So I'm gonna tell you a little bit about the facts on Molecule and why this thing actually works and what it does in your space to your air. So the Molecule has a dual filtration system. It has a pre-filter that traps larger particles like dust and pet hair and stuff like that. The other filter is a Pico filter. It breaks down those smaller pollutants that are teeny tiny that a lot of other air purifiers don't catch. I love how like techno savvy this thing is too. It's all run by the app, which makes it super simple and really easy to use. There's a bunch of different settings. One is auto, that's like the easiest setting. You can barely hear it. But there's actually a more silent version than this version, if you can believe it, and it's the silent version, that's what it's called. And that one just runs really, really quietly. It still is breaking stuff down. I can vouch, it is as quiet as a whisper. And then it also has another setting, which is the boost setting, and if you just dust or clean and you kind of think you've got a lot of stuff floating around in the air, or maybe you start it for the first time, you can turn it on boost. It's a little bit louder, but it really, like, high power gets a lot of that stuff cleaned. You can keep this guy on all night, and it's super energy efficient. It only uses about 20 to 85 watts of energy. It is this cute little leather strap, so it's portable. Super cute and sleek and beautiful. Really seriously into this air purifier. We've cleaned our purses, we've cleaned our air, now we are going to clean our sponges. Here's the deal with sponges. They just did a study in 2017 and they discovered that your kitchen sponge is pretty much just as dirty as your toilet, if not dirtier, meaning there's a lot of bacteria in a sponge. So here's a few tips when it comes to your sponges. Try to never use this guy on any raw meat substances, a cutting board, a knife, or anything. It's just a lot of bacteria and it kind of gets stuck inside your sponge. You can clean them It will reduce the amount of bacteria by like 60%. If you either pour boiling water on this or get it wet and put it in the microwave and nuke it. It doesn't sanitize it completely, but it does reduce a lot of the bacteria. Make sure that you replace this guy every so often. Even if it looks okay, it is not okay on the inside and it's just not worth it. But it's good to kind of replace these guys and not hang on to them for too long. Okay, before we jump into number four, the question of today's video is, what kind of phone do you have? Do you have an iPhone? Do you have an Android? Do you have a Windows phone? Do you have a phone that I haven't mentioned? Do you have a flip phone? Let's see how techie the Live Your Style fam is. Leave your comment. The next thing we need to clean is our phones. You need to clean the inside and the outside of your phone. Go get your phone and start to declutter either apps, folders, text messages, contacts of ex-boyfriends or people that you do not need to have in your phone. I think oftentimes we carry around a ton of like duplicate photos and screenshots and things that just take up a lot of space. Once I had like 50% of my phone that was taken up by iMessage. Once you guys clean the inside of your phone, then move on to the outside. As you know, your phone goes everywhere that you go and you guys get to take a shower every day. Shouldn't your phone? All I do to clean my phone screen is I take a microfiber cloth and then I make my own little mixture. You don't want to use any like super strong cleaning agents like Clorox or bleach or anything. If you water down some vinegar, so just do 50% vinegar, 50% water, mix it together. You can dip one of those microfiber cloths in there and then lightly wipe down your phone. Using vinegar is great. It'll remove a lot of the bacteria. Definitely get all the smudges off and make it look super clean and shiny. Okay, number five, last on our list of things to clean is your pillow. There was a study done, if you guys watch Kathy Lee Gifford and Hoda on the Today Show in the morning, you may have seen this episode where Kathy Lee cut open one of her pillows that was like, I don't know, 10, 15 years old. They sent it to the lab and they had it checked. But basically there was lots of pet dander, there was dust mites, there was skin cells, there was dust mite poop. Pretty gross. I try to change my pillowcase every couple of days. If you guys do have down pillows or synthetic down pillows, you guys are able to throw those in the wash and it will clean it up a little bit. But again, it does not sanitize it. It just reduces some of the bacteria in your pillow. I recommend you guys replace your pillows every 1 to 2 years to be safe. You guys will be good to go, nice and clean and very refreshed overall. Okay guys, those are the five things that are overlooked but should be cleaned immediately. Just commit a Saturday or something and just get it done. You will feel so much better. I know I feel so much better from getting that stuff cleaned. I just feel like I can breathe easier. It's just all around better. Thank you again to Molecule for sponsoring today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. It was kind of a fun, active one. And if you guys have not yet subscribed, you know what to do. Give it a thumbs up. Okay guys, I will see you guys next week. Bye-bye.